Hi everyone, in this video I'll walk you through a set of new features in SharePoint that Microsoft is rolling out. You have now the ability to co-author in real time with your colleague SharePoint pages. After some seconds, every change is saved and stored in the version history of the page. There are plenty of new improvements and addition to every web part of our SharePoint page. All right, let me walk you through every new addition. Let's go. And here I have a SharePoint page open in edit mode. So the header area that we can see here on top of the page is now called banner web part. And as an option here, I can change the background image if I want. Let me pick this one, for example. Then I can, of course, as always, decide the focal point to have on the background image. You can change again this, you can reset this web part. And then here as option, you have a bunch of level of hitting. So you can highlight the author of this post news. You can have a fade effect that we have now. You can highlight the image and title or just a plain text, just to make a post news very easy, or a color block. And finally, with the last one, we are able to overlap the image with the header. Of course, you can remove the outer if this is not in your mind to highlight, but this is it. Let me go with the image and title, the classic one, and this is the first new addition called banner web part. Now, let's say that in this page, I would like to highlight another portion of this content, let's say in this specific area. So in the search, I can type banner and here we go. Now here, I can highlight this part of the page by typing, for example, building, I'm going to remove. And here, for example, I can have a blank or a plain text just to highlight this part, and that's it. So now I can update the news, and here we go. I have two banner web part, the first one with the full width, and here just to highlight a second part of this page where we have a different topic. So this is an option now with the new banner web part. I am in edit mode again on this page. Now, let's say that I want to change the background of this section. I want to have something different in this area. I'm going to edit this section, and now what I have here as new options is background. I can change even the alignment, but in that background, I can apply very captivating background images like in this part. So I have now normal text here, then I have a different portion of this page with a different background in this section. I can even apply a different thing, and down below I can change the background image by having something different. Moreover, what I can do here, let me set another one, this one in black, or you can have a gradient if you want. You can apply, as I mentioned, another background image. Let's go with this one, for example. Let me set, and here we go. Looks very nice now. And if I go here on more settings, I have scale to fill, scale to fit, and tile or original size. So this is how you can apply the background image in the section. You can play with the alignment, you can have center and central, the overlay color. So you can have white or black, or you can even have a nice gradient effect. You can select even the direction of the gradient, top to bottom, bottom to top. You can change this. Let's go with this one. The overlay opacity, this will allow you to make more fancy your page. And this is how you can apply different styles to a specific session on a SharePoint page. Another addition target the text web part, but not only this one, every other web part with a title. So in this specific case, as we can see here, highlighting the text, the header of this text editor web part, is that we have a heading 3 as a level, but you can customize the font size. You can have bigger, or maybe you want to have smaller. So this is how you can play with the heading level in a text editor web part. So let me go back on 24. You have a default, which means that if I set heading 2, for example, I'm going to have as a default 28. And again, if I go on heading 3, I have always a default font size, but this, in any case, will give you the chance to customize this part. So even if you have a heading 3, you can change the font size. Another new addition is the ability to set a bullet list with different style. Selecting this one now, I am going and dropping down this menu, I can apply a different style level. So I have disk, circle, or I can even apply square. Now, going down, I can apply also a numbered list if I want, and here I can define the style level. So I can have numbered, alphabetical, or alphabetical small, or Roman, or finally Roman small. Very, very cool. So let me drop this down and let me do something here. So let me type just some text to see how this will look like. There we go. If I tap on tab, for example, this is automatically applied in the numbered list. I have also the list options available. This will allow me to start a new list if I want, or start list at a specific number. So here I have the first one, here I have again the first one because I set to start again in this list. But what I can do here is starting from a specific number. This could be, for example, 9 for any kind of reason. And there we go. I have now my 9 starting from here. Now you have a different way to handle the title and the name of your page. Here in the upper left corner, you have the name and the title of this page. Clicking on that, you can see in this new panel the title. You can change this one, and you can see even the location where this page is stored. Again, here I have even the version history. And this opens clicking on the link on the right side of this page. Here I can see that this is the current version. Giuliano has modified this page, and I have all version here. So now on the version history, I have also and a toggle button which highlights every change, and this is very, very cool. I can see that here that the theme, the section background has been changed. Even the title here is different, and this is very, very cool. Now, in a matter of seconds, I can see every change applied in real time, almost in the real time on the page. A new addition target, the image web part. I have an image here, and selecting this one, I can now apply a shape without installing any other crazy customization or additional custom web part. I am now able to apply a circle to an image, a triangle, square, hexagon, pebble, or teardrop. And moreover, I can click on advanced editing, and now I'm going to have the same user experience that you can see in OneDrive or SharePoint playing with images. Down below, I can rotate the image. I can click to apply a specific aspect ratio, or I can change or flip the image horizontally or vertically. I can crop the image. I can make some adjustment, like playing with lights and color applying the exposure, brightness, highlights. I can even apply a filter. Let's go with the golden one. And I have also markup. I can draw something on this image if I want by doing just a line. And then let's click on save. And now this change is automatically applied. Moreover, what I can do here is changing and resizing this image. Clicking here on resize icon, I can see now a border around this image, and now selecting the corner, I can adjust with my mouse the size of this image. Selecting again this other one, the last thing is the text overlay. This is also another cool addition, so I can play with the text. I can type here builders, and then I can drag this text where I want. Selecting the pencil, I can now change, apply the text options, styles, bold, italic. I have the font size, let's go with 32. Then I can change the text color, let's go with this one. I can change the text box color, I can have white, for example, the opacity, or the image color, overlay color. So let's go with dark, and this change the overlay of the entire image web part. That's it. Let's say that I want to share this page with my colleagues that they don't have access. So I can click on the drop-down share and then share page. Now, selecting the link settings, I have down below more settings like in OneDrive, and I can apply the set expiration date. So maybe I want to make this page visible just for a short period of time. And this is definitely a best practice, so you can avoid oversharing content in SharePoint. You have this option also for document libraries or specific item in a list in SharePoint. And this is really a nice best practice. You should always apply an expiration date so you can avoid that things are overshared. Now, my favorite new addition and new feature available in SharePoint Pages, which is co-authoring in real time, like Microsoft Loop in SharePoint Page News. Here I can see that Adele Evans is editing a text web part on this page. Scrolling down, I can see that Adele Evans is editing this specific web part, and this is very nice. So going on top, I can, for example, change the title of this web part, and automatically now every change is saved and a new version of the page is created. So clicking now on version history, I can see that the draft about 1 minute ago has been saved for the change applied by Adele Evans. Then we changed both and together something on the page. I edited the stream web part and Adele changed the text editor web part. I can click on the link, I can see immediately which web part is and where is located. Then clicking on the toggle button, I can see what change has been made on the web part. This is very cool as new addition. Something to keep in mind if you want to post and release this page as completed, and when you click on the button update news, a panel shows up and here inform you that other people are working on this news and editing this new news. So what you can do here is inform other colleagues that are working on this actively on this page and ask them to leave the page so you can release and publish the page. Here I am in the site content of our SharePoint site collection. And what I can do here, I can create in a few clicks an approval workflow behind a SharePoint list. So I have an inventory list. And now what I can do here, I can click on the drop-down automate, and there is this new option, configure approvals. Clicking on this toggle button, I will apply the same out-of-the-box approval workflow that you have when you create a new list with approval already there applied. So now I have the classic approval workflow with the new column available here, and this will allow me to trigger easily an approval workflow by defining the approver, adding details, and clicking on submit. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video with all these new additions in SharePoint. And if yes, please consider to subscribe, like, add a comment down below. Let me know what is your favorite new feature in SharePoint. I hope to see you next time. Bye.